Does your law firm perform legal services for clients after they pay? Well, then you need to know how to create invoices for services rendered when using QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. We will now assume that legal services have been performed for the client who had already paid in advance. Income from legal services has now been earned. We now owe the client less in future services as a result of performing some services today. For example, let's imagine on January 11, we perform legal services worth $3,000 for Alan Arby. Alan would like to receive a paid invoice for the service. Well, what would change in the trial balance if we performed a service that was already paid for in advance? If we perform the service, then income from legal services would increase and show up on the trial balance for the very first time as $3,000. But what would decrease is unearned legal fees. Because if we perform the service and earned some, then the amount unearned goes down. And of course, the customer's balance in the customer's records would also change. So, what will be the result? Well, income from legal services will appear on the trial balance for the first time as $3,000. And unearned income will decrease. Unearned legal fees will go down to $22,000 because we have now earned $3,000 of what was just earned, and we will record this event on an invoice. So I believe the date was January 11th, $3,000, and these will be the changes. So when we create an invoice, we go to the top left and click the plus sign, go to the left column and click invoice. Now this is the way QuickBooks Online, well, let's close the little tips. The invoice is automatically enumerated this way, and you can change the invoice number to anything you would like it to be, whether you are recording it now or you reopen the invoice and change it later. It's whatever you want, but I will leave the default. Now, the date will be January, I guess we'll put it January 4th, and the customer is Alan. And the product or service that we are going to put on this invoice comes from the items list that we had previously set up during the setup. It's legal services rendered, and the amount we earned for those legal services rendered was $3,000. Now, you may notice that we have a description field that you can type in anything you need that would help you remember the details of this event that you earned legal fees on January 4th. You could also type in to the message on statement or message on invoice if you feel it necessary. But at the moment we click this arrow and we choose save and close, the invoice has been added. Now again, this is just extra little messages that help you. Just click okay, I got it. And now when we look at save and close, I don't know why the item didn't get, well, actually, this is a new one. Close this. Leave without saving. Okay. It's all messed up. Click reports. Click the trial balance. And you can see the numbers are exactly as what we expected. Legal services income shows up for the very first time as $3,000, and unearned legal fees goes down to $22,000. We didn't change any cash amount. We just did work and earned service income. We can also check the most important report. Well, one of the most important reports is the transaction list by customer. You can now see both Alan's payment and his invoice listed here one by one. But this 9,000 is not a valid number because this is a negative and that's a positive. So this list, only rely on it as a list of transactions. The real balance is when you click reports, open invoice, and you see that Alan's balance is really only 3,000. And you may well ask, why is Alan's balance 3,000? If you open up the payment, you will see what invoices have automatically been applied to this payment. Double click. Now, this was the payment we made before the invoice. So later when we made the invoice, QuickBooks automatically placed this check mark here to tell us that this invoice has been applied to the payment that we received beforehand, and that's why the open invoice shows you the net amount of the balance. Let's try a second example. Let's imagine on January 14th, we perform legal services worth $4,000 for Betty Boop. Betty would like to receive a paid invoice for the service. So what will be the results? Well, income from legal services will increase by $4,000 because we just physically earned $4,000 more of legal services. And unearned income will become $4,000 less and show up as $18,000 because there is $4,000 less unearned now that we've earned $4,000. So let's go ahead and make the January 11th invoice for Betty. We click New, Invoice. Make sure we put the right date this time, actually I think it said January 14th, the other one was the 11th, I'll fix it later. Betty Boop, okay. Now, notice the invoice number is enumerated automatically, but you can make it anything you want. Click directly under product and service, click the pull down arrow. This is legal services rendered in the amount of $4,000. And that's all you have to do upon earning $4,000 worth of legal services. Save and close. And now you can see, well, if actually we're on the open invoice report, so you can see Betty's balance has decreased. And you say, why is Betty's balance now $4,000? Double click and open up the payment. The original payment back on the 2nd was $8,000, but at the moment we made a $4,000 invoice, QuickBooks Online clicked this check mark and applied the $4,000 invoice to this payment to show you the net balance of Betty on the open invoice report. And if we check reports, trial balance, you can see the results are exactly as what we expected. Cash in Chase Bank is still $25,000. We didn't touch it. But unearned legal fees decreased to $18,000 and legal service income increased to $7,000. And if your client wants a paid invoice, you can just click reports. And you can go to transaction list by customer, and every invoice and every payment is listed one by one. Now, how do we know if this invoice is paid? We double click and open it up and go right back to the window that we recorded it in. And because the payment was made first, and because QuickBooks Online automatically applies past payments to new invoices, we could just go ahead and click more. And click, well, where's print? Oh, print. We could preview or print or email. You know, we could click send email. That's a whole nother video. But the point is, we give the client a paid invoice to show and declare that we have earned the legal service income.